Cierra los ojos pa no mirarse.
Los Angeles, a bustling metropolis of over 10 million people, is currently composed of almost 50% Latinos and Latinas. Yet despite comprising nearly half the population, their voices are seldom heard in the mainstream media, and their lives are often absent or stereotypically portrayed. In downtown Los Angeles, a group of mothers at Leo Politi Elementary School are meeting each week for an autobiography writing class called the Family Album Writing Workshop. While learning elements of the writing process, such as pre-writing, editing, and revision, the women also have the opportunity to share their stories with each other and to gain strength from their collective experiences.
This program is called the Family Album Writing Workshop. It's a workshop where women write their life stories and learn about the writing process the way it is taught in elementary schools so that they can help their children with their writing. And during the workshop, I love that we create a safe space and environment where they can open up and talk about the issues that concern them the most, and that they can write about those issues and reflect.
Para mí fue una experiencia muy bonita porque a mí me sirvió personalmente como desahogo.
It was a wonderful experience because it served me as an emotional outlet. It was a way of getting out what I had never expressed, although I could have expressed it better in words. What happened in my childhood, themes that I hadn't even discussed with my family, I was able to express in writing. It has helped me a lot.
In our culture, we have such stereotypes about people from working class backgrounds. And I think one of the things that we tend to stereotype them as not being thinkers and readers. So partially, I was trying to offer a broader vision that says, you know, I really think that people can empower themselves where they are, that no matter where you are, you can begin the process of change and transformation.
To tell one's own narrative, one's own history, the injustices, the moments of triumph, the alliances, the pleasures, is to begin to turn oneself into a subject of history. It's the beginning of a kind of collective coming to consciousness about one's own situation in the world through exchanging histories, one's narratives, with other people and hearing the commonalities and differences between one's own story and other people's stories.
Saqué escribiendo en ese álbum.
While writing this album, I got out the wounds that I had kept inside. Not until I began to write and write did all these things come out. I am doing this because I feel that by writing about the separation with my husband, I'm going to get rid of a lot of hurtful things that are now inside of me. I feel that it will stop hurting, although I must admit that it does hurt to write and talk about it. For me, this is one of the most important things that has happened to me lately. My children know how everything happened, but I feel that by leaving it recorded on paper, it will help in the future. Perhaps it will help my daughter, or my son, or perhaps it might only help me.
The following is a translation of part of a story that one of the participants wrote during this workshop. From her story titled Lost Childhood, Maria Jovell writes,
"One day I was playing with my siblings on the corridor of the project where we lived. I remember seeing my little brother fall and did not get up again. I ran to tell my mom. She picked him up in her arms and took him to the emergency room at San Juan de Dios. My mom was told that he was stricken with polio, in other words, infantile paralysis. From then on, my little brother Toñito was unable to walk. Because I was the eldest, I didn't know what else to do but give him more caring and love. I always carried him and took him all the way to school. I would defend him from those who teased him and helped him in everything because my mom dedicated herself to work in order to provide us with whatever was needed. That is why I did not have a childhood and never played with any other girls. I never owned pretty dolls, I only owned rag dolls. Due to all this, I learned to be more responsible from an early age. I would fix lunch for my siblings the night before because we had to leave early in the morning since school was a mile away. Because my brother was on crutches, he could not walk fast enough, so I had to carry him to school. On many occasions, this would make us late. Throughout the years, I was always responsible for my siblings, until one day in which everything changed. My little brother began to suffer from headaches, fevers, and was throwing up. I was so frightened that I begged my mom to take him to the doctor, but she would not listen. I spent 2 days with my brother while my mother was at work and allowed valuable time to pass by. On the third day, at dawn, my brother had ceased to breathe at my side. This began another difficult time in my life. At 12, I had seen my brother leave us when he was only 10.
Participatory democracy is very difficult for people who have a double day of work, mm-hmm. right? I mean, when do they go to the meetings and so forth? And yet, women have deep interests in the safety of their children, the health of their children. But I would say that what is important is that those groups find ways of continuing to reflect upon their situation and more importantly, on the social structure within which they find themselves, that to ask where are the opportunities for changing this social structure.
Social transformation is a challenging yet crucial goal which requires struggle on many levels. These mothers, who have come together to share their pains, joys, and struggles, are planting the necessary seeds for a critical solidarity which can lead to change. Through collaboration, trust, and the courage to claim one's voice, these women are becoming agents of their own history, present, and future. En sus recuerdos, en la memoria de sus anhelos. Ay, melena negra, carita triste, rosa amarilla. Buscando vives tus días y noches una salida. Que un domingo libra este infierno tuyo por tu alegría. La desaparición.